The objective of this video is to describe the topics covered in the Debian Administrator's Handbook. So I just wanted to make a short series. This will probably be good for my operating systems class, but just a short series of videos kind of going over just general things in this handbook. So for part one here, I'll just go over the intro and the basics. So who are the authors of this fantastic book? Looks like we have a few of them, and this is kind of strange to me, the fact that we have three different copyrights, and of course they are different years. But maybe a takeaway from this page is that these two guys are responsible for giving us this book. Now, not surprising, anything related to Linux is going to have a Creative Commons license. Now, the book opens up with this whole duocracy philosophy, which I really like. Basically, right here they're saying that if you want to have a say on how something is done in Debian, you need to put yourself on the line and be ready to take the job on your shoulders. Blah, blah, blah. Anyone with enough skills, time, and motivation can have a real impact on the direction the project is taking. And next up, the book mentions that the International Space Station is using the Debian operating system. And then it says that version 8, it sounds like at the time of my reading, version 8 is the newest one. That one is called Jessie. So you'll find out in just a little bit why it's named this girl's name here. But computer science, maybe just technology, the tech industry in general, they just love these like code names, so. So that's version 8. We've gotten to 8 versions because of this whole duocracy philosophy. And how crazy would that be to know that you contributed to something that is then being used in space? So I just am a big fan of duocracy, and here's a nice little quote, maybe to encourage you to just do more in life. And what a great movie that is. If you haven't seen it, I'd highly recommend it. Well, here we are learning that the geographic information system uses Debian. So shout out to my student who is very interested in taking his life in that direction. Might want to become familiar with Debian if that's what you want to do. Now, where did Debian come from? In 1993, a guy named Ian Murdoch is going to primarily be responsible for it. So just to put yourself in the age of the times, 1993 there is when Deep Space Nine first aired. My favorite of all the Star Trek series. So Ian creates Debian using the Linux kernel, and I really like that the book mentions this, that strictly speaking, Linux is only a kernel, the core piece of software which sits between the hardware and the applications. Like when we say Linux, let's remember all of this. Debian and many other distributions out there exist, but the kernel is the thing that we call Linux. So here's a picture of a kernel just to bring it home. And now, for you to always remember where the name came from, Ian decided to take his girlfriend at the time, Deborah, or Debbie, and take his name and her name and combine it, and thus we have Debian. So version 8 being Jesse, maybe that's why they decided to go with a girl's name. So it doesn't take the book too long to get into some technical details here. I found it interesting that Debian now sports two new architectures, so ARM64 and the PowerPC one, are the two 64-bit types of architecture it supports. Now, ARM could be big or little Indian. It looks like PowerPC is little Indian. And this is just one of my favorite pictures to think about when I think of little versus big Indian. So in the case you're new to this whole idea, let's say we have a value like this. If it's stored in the big Indian style, it'll be stored exactly as you see it. But your desktop computers are typically running x86 architecture, so typically it's more like this. That is, that value is stored like that. There's good reason for it to be stored that way. When you're just think about when you're doing math, when you do like 10 plus, let's say 11, you begin at the smallest part right here, the 0 and then the 1. Like, you start at the small end, so thus, going with little Indian, you start at the little end to do all your math, and if a computer is designed that way, typically it can work just a little bit faster. So why even bother learning big Indian? Well, not all processors are going to have this style of memory storage. I suppose it makes sense that in data networking, they are going with this whole big Indian style. When transferring data, that is. So if you ever have trouble remembering that little Indian is one of the most popular styles, just remember this rhyme, math begins at the little end. See if I can circle there, copyrighted Professor H. I'm just kidding. Maybe I should use some beats in my next video. Well, anyways, that's funny that they drop some technical details on you, and then they end up saying things like, thank you to all of these organizations for the financial donations that the Debian project has received. One that jumped out to me was this offensive security. They're the guys who made Kali Linux operating system, or a distribution of Linux I use quite often. And I noticed this Proxmox name, I swear I've heard it on some IPsec videos before, so. So if Debian is related to the cybersecurity industry, that is another good reason for me to go through this handbook, I figure. And another reason to go through the handbook, I mean, the guy, Roland, an author, is in his acknowledgments saying some of my favorite authors, and these guys and girls are completely fictional authors. Oh, and don't forget Douglas Adams here. Maybe William Gibson being my favorite, that's why I went with the picture here. But yeah, some really good authors, and the guy decided to acknowledge them in this administrator's handbook. Now, before I end the video, I should probably just talk a little bit about downloading the ISO file so that you can get your hands dirty with Debian. Here is where you would go to download a copy, though there's many resources out there for you to use. And if you remember, we're just talking about architectures and how different processors use different architectures. You want to make sure you know what your processor's architecture is. That way you can choose the right ISO file to download. Now the handbook goes into some basic differences between the architectures. It says each architecture is differentiated primarily according to its processor. So yeah, that processor being the most important component on your computer when you're downloading an operating system. Later, they mention that a program is created by writing source code. The source code is a text file composed of instructions in a given programming language. Before you can use the software, it is necessary to compile the source code, which means transforming the code into a binary, which is a series of machine instructions executed by that particular processor. So the compiler needs to connect to the processor it's compiling for, or else your program in this case, the operating system will not be able to work correctly. And if you want to learn more about compilers, I have a few videos out there just giving like an ELI 5 of how compilers work. Okay, to wrap up this video, they mentioned meritocracy, so they just want you to be assured that if you're using a Debian operating system, the decisions of what to accept and what not to accept is based purely on merit. The way they measure it is through competence. Here's that term duocracy again. And I really like that they mention meritocracy right here. Definition I found that I enjoy is merit is a combination of IQ and effort. And for people like myself, I am 95% effort. So when you download your ISO file, use whatever hypervisor you like to run operating systems on. There's plenty of videos out there explaining how those work, and I even have one on VMware. That's a hypervisor you can use to go ahead and play around with this operating system as we go through this new series, just explaining the types of things you can do on Debian. So in the next video, I'll start by talking about patching the operating system, and I'll see you then.